They are here among us. They are watching, listening, waiting. Some of you may be one of them, and you don't even know it yet. But I know your superpower. You are immortal. So am I. Immortal, but not quite like the movies. Today, I'll tell you why. My name is Joaquim Vives. I am a researcher at the Blood and Tissue Bank, a non-for-profit institution in Barcelona. The key of this type of immortality is in your genes, in your cells, in your tissues. It's in your organs. Each one of us has 8 organs and 200 tissues in our bodies that can be recycled to help others, saving lives or improving the quality of life. But please don't panic. There are other forms of immortality that don't require you passing away. Question: has any of you ever given blood or plasma? Please raise your hands. Thank you. Thank you so much. Our community here in Catalonia has more than 7 million inhabitants. 7 million of potential donors or potential patients. We need approximately every day 1,000 blood donations and 400 donations of plasma every single day, 7 days a week, to ensure self-sufficiency. At the Blood and Tissue Bank, I learned that the shelf life of blood is very short, and patients receive blood every time they need it. But we are not providing these patients with the capacity to regenerate their own blood. And artificial blood is not an option yet. These are some of the reasons that explain why a continuous flow of donations is required. A different approach is based on the use of umbilical cord blood, stored in public banks like ours and listed on an international registry, ready for being used in case it matches a patient in need, anywhere in the world. Donations like this make possible personalized treatments that could not be generated otherwise in the laboratory. That is a reason for asking people like you and me, to become donors and use our cells and tissues for transfusion or transplantation. However, the clinical use of these donations is restricted to very specific pathologies, like some types of cancer. So we need new therapies. We really need them. In this scenario, the act of donation itself is only one part of the solution, because cells and tissues need to be processed and combined properly to become safe and effective personalized treatments. And that's precisely the goal of an emerging field in regenerative medicine, in which literally innovation is fueled by the creativity of scientists developing new approaches to address unmet clinical needs. With this, a new category of medicines. We call them advanced therapies. And they're indeed pharmaceutical drugs, like ibuprofen or paracetamol. But rather than chemical molecules, they result from the manipulation of biological structures to produce engineered living medicines. There's been intense research in this field in the last decades, but only 18 advanced therapies have been approved so far in Europe. And most of them still use donations from the same patient. This approach addresses important safety aspects like compatibility, but it's not ideal. Logistics are complex, it is expensive, and the quality of the donation may be poor because it comes from the same patient who is suffering a pathology and has a medical history. In some cases, like genetic disorders, it may make sense to edit a single gene on the patient's own cells to reverse the disease. But there's been a gradual shift toward using cells from healthy donors, having specific features that make their donation suitable as a starting materials of advanced therapies. And there you are. How do you think we make these advanced therapies? You can imagine that the donations need to be processed in a way that cells and tissues are isolated for further use. Tissues are prepared in a way that they minimize the rejection by the patient and is presented in a format that is useful for the surgeons. On the other hand, the cell types of interest are isolated from the source tissue, expanded in a laboratory using devices like this that help us to scale up production of sufficient numbers. Sometimes, new functionalities can also be added to the cells by genetic engineering. And finally, cells are used on their own or combined with scaffolds and shaped into the format that is needed for clinical use. This is what really fascinates me, this plasticity of the components of our bodies. Adia, my youngest son, here in the picture, he told me that he knows exactly what I'm talking about and showed me the great potential of modeling. Indeed, tissues can be processed in a way that the elements are presented as hydrogels, for instance, and we can use them as bio-inks for 3D printing of new tissues with unique architecture and function. I have another example I'm sure you will appreciate, because I know there is an immunologist inside you. Come on, it's been 2 years of pandemic, so you know almost everything about viruses, don't you? Okay, what about this? We could isolate white cells from the blood of a donor who has been previously immunized against the virus, coronavirus or adenovirus, you name it, then stimulate memory lymphocytes, and finally use those virus-specific cells in the management of patients needing some additional help to fight against viral infections. Today, it is also possible, and actually relatively easy, to reprogram adult cells to equip them with the potential to specialize into different cell types of our body. This is a remarkable tool that we can use on donated tissues, regardless of the tissue, and transform them into the precise cells that are needed for treatment. This way, umbilical cord blood units with characteristics that make them highly compatible with the population are currently being reprogrammed in public banks like ours, produce an immortal master cell bank that we can use to generate the precise cells that are needed for treatment. All these new methods and technologies make possible to increase the variety of flavors, quantities, and shapes of advanced therapies to address the individual needs for every patient. Please remember that advanced therapies are medicines, and they must be developed and tested as any other drug before receiving authorization for marketing by the regulatory authority. In our case, it is centralized by the European Medicines Agency. This is the ABC, and must be done this way to guarantee their safety, efficacy, and consistent quality in each manufacturing process. We follow these guidelines in collaboration with hospitals, research institutes, and universities. Together, we also participate in events like this to communicate scientific developments, because we need a science-educated society. We need all of you to distinguish between the hype and hope and what can be a realistic translation of advanced therapies into possible cures. Unfortunately, we constantly find commercial ads of unproven cell-based therapies, speculative stem cell banking, and medical tourism from institutions operating in environments of lax medical regulations. And don't forget that those were your genes, your cells, and your tissues, and now they transform into drugs encoding your own biological signature. Who protects that? Who protects the donor? Ethics, regulations, and also a strict quality management systems. They all play an extremely important role in all steps of the creation of advanced therapies, from the ethics of tissue donation to balancing the risks of administering a novel treatment to patients. Advanced therapies are here. They are here. And they are entering into the clinical arena as a result of the participation of many and diverse stakeholders. They all push scientific progress into revolutionary medicines and challenge our society to promote health equity and ensure that patients get access to safe and effective treatments. And please never forget that advanced therapies are here in the very first place because their individual decision. The altruistic action towards a society of the donors. Look, giving a part of oneself to help others is the most beautiful and generous act of kindness that a human being can do. We, as scientists, are here to transform your generosity into hope, and this way we'll make a part of you somehow immortal.